My most viewed videos have all been mouse experiments, so I want to do another experiment, and this one is going to test how big of a just a vertical gap the mouse needs to get through. And this closes like this, and it's going to be computer controlled interactively. So there's just a little DC motor that goes right here, and that runs very slowly so that I can just run it for a fraction of a second to make the gap smaller every time. And to keep this thing from breaking itself as it hits the limit, just in case there's a bug in my software, I've been going through my junk bin and trying to find the right kind of switches to use for that. And I've got a limit switch here. So as this opens all the way, it hits that switch, and there's another limit switch in here like this. So when it's nearly closed, it hits that switch, so that way I can wire that so the hardware protects itself if the software goes funny. So I've got this put together with the limit switches and wired up, and I built a case around it because I don't want the mice messing with the switches of the mechanism. And here's my Raspberry Pi computer, and I've got a relay board on here, and I've got a little Python script right here to pulse these alternately for 12 seconds. And if I run that, this one opens the gate and it keeps going until it hits that switch there, and that shuts it off. And now going in reverse, it keeps going until it hits this switch. And this is now doing a final test before I set it out in the cold. I've got a plexiglass cover on here to keep the mouse from jumping over it. I've got a little compartment to put sunflower seeds so that the mouse can go back and forth and fetch all of those. The electronics are all inside this sealed container except for the camera module, which is right here. And I've got one power adapter for the Raspberry Pi and another one to power the motor. And for internet, goes onto here, and I've got that hooked into power over Ethernet to this antenna. The main reason for using this antenna is I'm out of Wi-Fi range where I'm going to set it up, and I don't want to have to run a wire through the window for this. So here's my inside point-to-point wireless antenna, which is aimed at that corner right there, which is where the shed is. And this is the shed where I set things up yesterday, except I kind of ran out of daylight for filming it and then had to take care of the kids and whatnot. So there's the apparatus and the Pi and two LED light strips. Only problem is right now I can't reach that Pi over the network, and I've already verified that this thing here, the antenna's up here where it goes down here to the power over Ethernet thing. Internet gets to here, so it's something with the Pi, and unfortunately that is permanently connected to the setup here, so I have to take the whole shebang inside to test it. So I've got it set up inside again, hooked up directly to the LAN, and that seems to be working. And it recorded time-lapse images all night, and here's snow falling onto it around midnight. So the Pi was running the whole night, I just couldn't reach it. I don't know why. I'm none the wiser. I guess I'll put it outside again and try again. So I set this up and hooked it up, and once again it didn't work. And I brought out the laptop computer and checked it again, and the networking worked. And then I realized I probably, the second time around, didn't push the network cable all the way in. I don't know why it stopped working the first time around. It might have been just because it was -9 Celsius that the Raspberry Pi isn't rated to go that low. People say it works that low, but who knows. I still haven't had a mouse, but I've only had it set up for one night. So hopefully this apparatus will continue to work and I will get mice again. I had actually set up some bait right there, and that bait got replaced with mouse poop quite recently, so I'm pretty sure mice are around. But maybe with all this fresh snowfall, they haven't been showing up. So now it's a waiting game, and hopefully I'll get some good footage. If I do get good footage, it'll be a video that gets millions of views. If I don't, it'll be a ho-hum video. It's a crapshoot with this sort of thing. So whatever I will get will be in a future video. This is just a vlog about setting things up.